What's up guys, this is Y and today I'm gonna show you how to convert any of your photographs into an amazing watercolor painting within Photoshop without using any third-party plugins or softwares. And if that's what you're looking for, let's dive into it. Cool, so this is the picture I'm gonna use. You can download this picture from unsplash.com. So first thing, I'm gonna just select this background layer and I'm gonna press Ctrl plus J to duplicate it. Cool, I'm gonna go to Filter, Blur and Box Blur. Cool, so I'm gonna make the radius back to 1 and I wanna see a nice texture like that. I'm gonna keep increasing the radius of the blur till that texture becomes smooth. So the texture is becoming smooth at around 35 pixels. So I'm gonna just hit OK. Cool. And now I'm gonna change the blending mode to pin light. Cool. So right now you can't see any effect going around, but as soon as I create a curves adjustment layer and turn on the clipping mask and I just decrease the curve like so, boom, you get a nice watercolor effect, right? And if you don't want to mess with the colors, just change the blending mode of the curves adjustment layer to luminosity, but I'm gonna just keep it at normal. Cool. Okay, that looks cool. So if you want to further increase this effect, create a levels adjustment layer and just upgrade the mill slider and just keep experimenting until you see a nice effect there. Okay, so I'm gonna just double click in here and turn on the clipping mask, and now I'm gonna press Ctrl Shift Alt plus E to generate a stamp visible layer. I'm gonna go to Filter and Filter Gallery, and I'm gonna select this watercolor effect. Cool, and I'm gonna keep the shadow intensity at 1 and texture somewhere around there and hit OK. So this is gonna apply the effect to the stamp visible layer. Cool, so if this is what you're looking for, you're good to go. But I'm gonna just double click here and open the blending options. I'm gonna just move this slider towards the right and I'm gonna press Alt and click here. I'm gonna just move them so that it creates a nice smooth transition. I'm gonna move this slider and click and Alt click here. Like so. Cool. You can just decrease the opacity if you want and just create a group, Ctrl plus G, and rename this to watercolor. Cool, so this is the before and this is the after. Pretty simple, right? So this was it guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell notification icon so that you never miss a future update. Also, if you like this tutorial or learn something new today, please make sure to give me a thumbs up. And if you have any query or feedback to give, the comment section is all yours. And I will see you in the next video. Till then, peace.